By now, you're receiving data about the calls and potential leads, but how do you report on the data received? If you just want basic call data, you can head over to AdWords. CallRail also has raw data, but they include additional caller information and metrics to help you analyze marketing to make data-driven decisions. I'm Adam Arkfeld, owner of Paracore, a pay-per-click lead generation agency. This is the 7th video of 10 in my ultimate guide to using CallRail for your PPC marketing. It's a comprehensive video series for using CallRail, a third-party call tracking system, with your pay-per-click marketing. Once you're done with this series, you'll be a call tracking and CallRail guru. If ever you want to jump to a specific section of the video, we've included timestamps in the description below. You can always watch previous videos as a refresher or skip ahead to other videos if I'm covering a topic you're already familiar with. Today, we're covering reporting. We'll be talking about call tagging, call attribution, form attribution, calls by landing page, and lead funnel reporting. There are other reporting options offered by CallRail, but we found these to be the most helpful when managing call tracking. Before we get started on the built-in reporting features, I want to touch on using tags to report on qualified leads in your call history. Tags are an alternative method that we use at Paracore that's managed in the activity dashboard. By using custom tags, you can create filtered reports to show how many calls were qualified leads, duplicates, or irrelevant. In order to use tag filtering, you need to listen to each call and tag it based on the recording. For example, if someone is calling about a job and is not new business for your company, you might tag that call as other, which would not show in your report of qualified leads. To generate a report using tags, you need to first set up your campaign tags in your CallRail account. We covered that topic thoroughly in video 6 if you need to go back for a refresher. If you check out the activity dashboard page, you'll notice you're viewing the full call log page by default. This is what you'll see when you're on that screen. You'll notice that nothing is filtered even though we have calls, so all the calls, relevant and irrelevant, are showing. In order to report calls related to your tags, you'll filter the report to see just calls by tag. The filter icon in the upper right-hand corner opens up the screen where you'll pick your options. Choose the date range you want to view, select the tags to filter, and then apply the changes. After you've applied the filters, you'll only see those calls that have the tags you selected. Now you can focus on the most relevant calls and report on the important metrics to your clients. If you want to export the calls into a spreadsheet, you can do so by clicking the export button under the graph. You can save that report as a CSV file or print it. The tagging method is what we started with at Paracore and allows us to be extremely flexible in our call segmenting. If you're new to CallRail, we think it's a good place to start. Okay, let's switch gears a little and talk about commonly used reports in CallRail. These reports provide insights about your callers, which your clients will love. All the following reports can be accessed by clicking the main reporting icon that looks like a pie chart at the top of your screen. Let's start with call attribution. The call attribution report provides insights into the sources and interactions that are generating calls. First, if you have more than one company you're tracking calls for, you'll want to choose the company in the dropdown in the upper right. Then select call attribution under the acquisition list. You'll notice the other reports we're covering in this video are on that list as well. The first view you'll see is the pie chart that shows which sources and campaigns are bringing calls to your business. You'll also see the total number of calls, first-time callers, and average duration. If you click the link number under total calls or first-time callers, you'll see the list of calls in that category. If you're tagging those calls, you'll be able to easily determine if a particular source is generating good leads or not. You can also group your data by source and interaction to view the data differently. You might want to see what lead sources like referrals or paid media are generating calls, or you might want to see how many times callers have interacted with your company. If you want to get really granular with your data, you can apply filters to each of the reporting views we're talking about today. For example, filter by number to see calls by a specific tracking number, or filter by source to see where calls are coming from. Filtering by duration might be beneficial to see how long each call is taking your call representatives. The lead status filter is also incredibly beneficial, but it does require automated lead classification to be set up, which we covered in video 6. As we discussed before, tags are powerful if you're reviewing each call and tagging appropriately. The toggle for first-time conversations can be applied to find calls that are coming from new callers. The keyword filter allows you to search for keywords you're bidding on that brought calls into your business, or you can apply the refer filter to see if any third-party websites brought calls into your business. If you're watching a particular ad or landing page, you also have the option of filtering data by campaign or landing page. After you made your filter selections, apply them to generate your report and export or save it from the dashboard. Another report we found surprisingly helpful is the form attribution report to see how your website forms are performing and how much traffic they receive. The form attribution report provides insight into the sources that are generating form submissions on your website. The form submission tracking was a surprising tracking benefit for call systems like CallRail. It allows you to aggregate your different types of tracking like calls and form submissions into just one space. If you're using a keyword pool, the calls by landing page report detail the pages on your website that callers landed on first when they came to your site. You can use this report to learn more about how callers interact with your website and determine which pages provide the most conversions. For example, if a caller visits your website and lands on paracore.com, then visits several other pages on your website, paracore.com will represent this caller's data in the calls by landing page report. In order to capture a visitor's session and correlate it with landing pages, this report requires keyword level tracking with dynamic number insertion script installed on your website. We covered number insertion, including dynamic scripts, in video 3. If you want to run this report, make sure you have them installed before you continue. Okay, we're going to talk about the final report in our video, which is the lead funnel report. The lead funnel report provides a breakdown of how many of your callers became leads. Using this information, you can see which of your marketing sources are driving the most calls to your business and how many of those calls translate into leads. Callers are visitors to your website that dialed one of your keyword tracking numbers. Leads are callers that have been classified as a lead using keyword spotting or lead classification, which we covered in video 6. The columns below the pie chart illustrate which sources and campaigns bring callers into your business, as well as how many of these callers became leads. So the look of the reports page is slightly different. However, the filter choices are exactly the same as the other reports we've covered in the video. So there you have it. That's your overview of generating CallRail reports for your PPC campaigns. Make sure you check out our next video about CallRail call flows, where we'll cover how to set up call flows to ensure your prospective leads are handled perfectly. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button and make sure you click that red subscribe button below this video to receive updates on the series and more. Also, we'd like to hear from you. If you have questions or comments, please post them below, and I will see you in the next video.